It's not your first brush with comedy.
Am I, really?
Well, The Office. I'm a huge Office fan. And when David Brent supported a little-known band called Texas.
When the Office first ran, my mate came and was like, get the television on! I was like, turned on, I was like, bloody hell. Couldn't believe it. It was a good cue card for me to put in my little folder to be in that.
We're both good in our own fields. I'm sure Texas couldn't run and manage a successful paper merchants. Yeah? I couldn't, you know, do what... Actually, I could do what they do. And I think they knew that even back then. Probably what spurred them on.
Could Texas run a paper merchant?
I reckon I would probably be bloody good at it, to be quite honest with you. I think I could take it on. I reckon I could do his job.
We're back with the Orange Playlist Tour in Kent. And your favourite future hit this week is...
PH, fat. To tune off.
Corelli's fit. Sweet.
You're heavy, man, I swear.
This week's guest is Charlene Spiteri, rock star and most recently comedy partner to Peter Keir. So far, we've seen her past, present and future track selections. So now let's find out the last two songs that make up her Orange Playlist.
Ali and I both get propositioned by this girl. He said, I'll take the two of you. I sort of think rock and roll is sleeping with hundreds of women, and I've never slept with a woman.
What a beautiful place. Where are we?
We are in Angelina's at the moment, which is famous for hot chocolate. I used to come here in the mornings because it's just round the corner from my flat. I used to come round here and just to have hot chocolate and do all my meetings and that in the morning. Try and get other people to pay for it because I was a bit skint at the time.
Now, the new album, Red Book, tell me a bit about it. What's the inspiration behind it?
I don't think you ever really know what your inspiration is when you start making a record. Your inspiration, the truth is, your inspiration is to make another record. Full stop. It's like, all right, that last record didn't do as well as we expected. We better get our, you know, backsizing gear and make a new record.
Does it not get any easier?
I think it actually gets harder. It gets harder because you kind of become quite aware of the pitfalls and you know how it can go wrong and you know that you can never rely on anything. So I think, you know, the older you get, plus you become really cautious as you get older as well, don't you?
You have sort of like been offered quite a few acting roles in the past, haven't you? You were offered a part in Moulin Rouge, I believe.
I was making the greatest hits and I was very flattered to be asked and said, thank you very much, it's very kind of you, but I need to go and make a record and, you know, be with my band.
I'm so tired of being alone, I'm so tired of home.
This has been quite a challenging year for you, hasn't it?
Takes a little bit more hard work nowadays, being a mum. So it's like, it's kind of like organisation more than anything else. It's weird because people think it softens you. I would say it makes you a lot harder. I think you become very straight to the point, which can sound quite hard to other people on the outside. Something just because you've not got time to like do the niceties, you're kind of like, so what's the answer?
Now tell me about your dedication track.
My dedication is The Gorillas and Dare.
And who are you dedicating that track to?
I'm dedicating it to my daughter, Mr. Kid.
A very unusual name, Charlene. You plumped for a rock star name.
I did, kinda. But then again, my name's Charlene Spiteri. I mean, it ain't exactly Glaswegian, is it? And she's mad on music. She's right at that point where, you know, she's like, let's get some music on and dance. She's really into that. And she's mad on the Gorillas, and she's obsessed by Noodle and the Gorillas, and just thinks that she's God, and won't basically go out unless she's got stripy socks on, which can be quite difficult when you're in a hurry. And I do that thing, they're all in the laundry. Get dressed and take your Batman outfit off.
Sean Ryder is involved in that track.
Love Sean Ryder.
What is it about Sean you love?
He makes me laugh uncontrollably. Plus, he buys things out the snips in the papers, which makes me really laugh. He always looks at those adverts for things like super lift shoes. I remember having a conversation one time because we were talking about, like, all pop stars are short. He was making me laugh. He says, that's why I have super lift insoles in my shoes. And I said, so what happens if you end up back at a girl's house and you take your shoes off and you shrink about 6 inches? He goes, well, that's when my super lift socks come into play. Love him for that alone. How couldn't you?
How rock and roll are you these days, Charlene?
I've never been rock and roll. I sort of think rock and roll is sleeping with hundreds of women and throwing televisions out of hotel windows. And I've never slept with a woman. I don't think you have, like, the professional groupies of back in the day of, like, the...
Cock rock.
Yeah, the sort of plaster casters. Don't think you get them. Yeah. The I'm with the band mode.
Not with Texas.
Mind you... There's been some moments. The funniest one was when Ali and I both got propositioned by this girl who said, I'll take the two of you. And Ali and I looked at each other and kind of went, it's OK. Terrified at her wits. She was rock and roll, we weren't.
You have sort of, like, tussles with the sort of fronting side of it.
There's a price you pay for being the front person in a band, and that's just the way it is. And I'm pretty realistic with that. I'm like, yeah, well, there's really great perks that I have for being the front person of the band, and then there's the other bits that are not so great. I love making music and I love performing music, but I have absolutely no interest in being a celebrity, to be honest with you. That's my tussle that I kind of find difficult sometimes to balance.
Marvin Gaye has been such a big influence on you. You've gone for your all-time favourite is a Marvin Gaye track. Which one have you gone for?
I chose Heard It Through the Grapevine. I love when men sing in a way that is so vulnerable and breakable and beautiful, but then they'll just, like, completely, like, blow you away by just having such great strength behind something, and I think Marvin Gaye's the ultimate at that. She's been such a massive influence on the musically, you know, vocally, lyrically, everything. About a record is that a record's supposed to be your life. You know, when every great record that I've ever loved throughout my whole life has been a song that I've kind of been able to put my life and all my friends and my people into that song and help me work out things as well. And Marvin Gaye always did that for me. I love that kind of music, it touches me. It ain't called soul for nothing.
Charlene, thank you for inviting us to Paris.
Thank you for coming.
It was delightful.
Thank you for coming to my wonderful city.
It has been so intact to your life. Thank you very much. And that was your Orange Playlist.
Thank you. And I enjoyed it. Thanks.
We can have our chocolate now.
I know. Look at my cup. Empty.
Look how
thick that chocolate is. That's what you call real hot chocolate.
Join me again next week for a very special show when we'll be finding out the all-time favourite Christmas songs and memories of some of this series' guests, including Ozzy Osbourne, Tommy Lee and Yoko Ono. See you then.
But before we go, our competition's giving you the chance to win this Nokia 3G N70 mobile phone. Just answer this week's question. Which top comedian stars in the new Texas video? Is it A, Al Murray, B, Peter Kay, or C, Bobby Ball? To enter, just call 0901 299 3301, or you can text your answer A, B, or C to 64343. Full terms and conditions are on our website at itv.com/playlist. Good luck, and I'll see you again next week.
Thank you.